In this part, I will show how to generate quite a simple XML file. In the next part, we will construct a complex XML. To start, create a new SSIS package and drag and drop export XML task from SSIS toolbox into the control flow. Then double click on export XML task for editing. First of all, you will need to create a connection. Select either ODB, ADO.NET or ODBC type of connection. We will use ODB connection. Once you have created the connection, you can simply enter the tables you want to export. Separate table names with the pipe symbol or check the example below to see how to select tables for export using a pattern search. You can also exclude tables or views from pattern search. Using customers pipe orders percent will export three tables as is, each to a different file. However, if you need a custom XML layout, you will need to use custom layout option. Let's say you have the table orders with this data and want to produce this kind of XML. XML's outer element is request. Import orders element has a static attribute version with value 1.0. Within import orders, there is a static element add only with value true. Then orders element embraces all order elements. Each order element has an attribute ID with its actual ID. Inside each order element, you have all the details of an order. To begin, go to tab Custom Layout. Check Single Dataset Array. I will explain why we need it in a moment. Right-click on Datasets and click Add Dataset. Enter a dataset name, row element name, select the connection, and table orders. You can also use a SQL query to define a dataset. If your SQL query is dynamic, then you can use an SSIS variable. In this demo, we will use a table. Right-click on Mappings and select Add Unbound Nested Element menu item to add XML element named Import Orders. Right-click on element Import Orders and select Add Attribute to add version attribute. Once the window appears, select Add Static Value option and fill in a name and a value. Again, right-click on element Import Orders, but this time select Add Static Value element to add add-only element. Then fill in a name and a value. To add orders under Import Orders element, once again right-click on Import Orders and select Add Document Array menu item. Now we can get back to Single Dataset Array option. By default, Add Document Array requires two datasets, parent and child, which we will use in the next part of the video. Thus, we needed it to produce an array of elements using just one dataset. To proceed, enter orders for element name and order for row element name. Now, right-click on item orders and select Add Attribute menu item. This will add ID attribute. Select order ID as source column and then change output alias to ID to match the name of the attribute. It's time to add order elements. Right-click on orders and select Add Element. Use Add Multiple option and select the required columns. To change ordered on node's name to match the one in the output XML, right-click on the node and change the output alias to date. Now go to XML options tab to update order date format. The last modification we need to do is change root element's name to request. Among many options in XML options tab, you can change file encoding or character set, do not output properties with null value, and do not output XML declaration node. With export XML task, you can split output XML. Just go to Split Options tab and enable the option to split by file size or by rows number. Finally, go to Target tab and select the target destination of your XML. You can either directly enter a path into the text box or select a variable which is set to a path. You can also use a target connection. Using a connection enables you to save to a flat file, Amazon S3 storage, Azure Blob storage, FTPS or SFTP. In this scenario, we will use a direct path. Export XML task also supports overwriting target file, appending to an existing file, or compressing a file. Let's open destination folder and execute the task. Finally, let's compare the generated XML with the result we expect using Visual Studio Code, a popular text editor. As you see, both XMLs are identical. This concludes export XML task demonstration and how to generate a simple XML file. In the next part, you will learn how to use XML file destination to generate a more complex XML file.